Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Sanity Daily in partnership with Breslev.org. I hope everyone is staying safe, and I hope everyone's feeling well. And today we're going to continue our lessons in Likutei Etzes, the Book of Advice. Today we're in the chapter of Eretz Yisrael, Israel. And today we're going to learn a beautiful lesson. Lesson five. And here it goes. Eif shalav el Eretz Yisrael kim al yedei yisurin. You can't get to Eretz Yisrael unless you have some type of obstacle, pain, something. Something comes along with it. Because we know the Torah that the Chazal teach us, that a Kodesh Baruch Hu said that he has three great things for us, for Klal Yisrael. And what is that? Torah, Eretz Yisrael, and Olam Haba. And we know that Torah comes with Amelus. You have to study, you have to work hard to understand Torah. Torah doesn't just come easily, right? Eretz Yisrael also, you have to work for it. It just doesn't come to us easily. It comes with Yisurim. Now, the Rebbe says, and, of course, Olam Haba. Anyway. Vikra Yisurim Haim Hamoinim Harishoyim Moitzi Dibas Oretz. But the main Yisurim, the main pain comes from the Rishoyim, from the wicked ones that speak ill about the land of Israel. The most important thing that people always, if you speak to people, they'll tell you, well, if I go to Eretz Yisrael, how will I make parnos in Eretz Yisrael? My Rebbe, Zalzayin Gezunten Shtark, Reb Chaim Kramer, he always says, the same God that provides for me in Chutz Loretz can provide for me in Eretz Yisrael. It makes no difference where I am. If I'm going to make a parnasa, I can make a parnasa here, I'll make a parnasa there. It makes no difference. For someone to delude themselves to think that if I'm in America, I can make more money. It's a delusion. The parnasa comes from the Rabbi Nishalayim. Anyway, and then these kind of things are the Dibas Rav from the Rishayim. These are they speaking ill about it. So you can't make a parnasa. You can't do this. The education is no good. The healthcare is not developed. They speak all this stuff. Nonsense. The wild is that they tell us Eretz Yisrael is the best healthcare system. Eretz Yisrael is economy is doing very, very well. But they'll tell you all kind of other things. But being mamshich the Torah, drawing the Torah from the tzaddik. Again, when we listen to the tzaddikim, the true tzaddikim, and we listen to what they have to say, right? When we listen to what they have to say, not like it was in the Midbar, right? Moshe Rabbeinu was saying that the Eretz Yisrael is great, and the Meraglim said they had bad things to say. Same idea. It's the same thing. History repeats itself all the time. But if you listen to the tzaddik, the Moshe Rabbeinu of today, and you listen to those tzaddikim, and they're telling you, and they give you good advice, and you take it in, and you accept it honestly, that's the greatest thing. Then you could merit to subdue. And to get rid of any of those minias. Okefi shleimus ha-teirish ha-zeich la-hamchich betikin gadol be-yoyser. And the more of the Torah you get from the tzaddikim, the more you learn from Chazal, the more you learn, the more Torah you have. And you see how wonderful Eretz Yisrael really is. K'makein zeich ha-lachnia ha-moinim v'lov el Eretz Yisrael. Oy, we should all be zeicher. We should be zeicher to this. We should be zeicher to listen to the tzaddikim, to listen to the true Torah. And by doing that, we can all be zeicher to come to Eretz Yisrael. Yemitz Hashem, with Mashiach Tzikeinu, V'yaz Koyal Tzedek. Thank you everyone for listening. And I hope everyone is benefiting by these classes. And I do thank you for your wonderful, kind words of chizik that I get in my emails. And I thank you very much for that. And I would like to wish everyone a wonderful day. Kol tov.